Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK and welcome to another episode of DGN, Dagan's Guitar News here on the PMT House of Rock YouTube channel. A weekly news roundup show where we chat about all the awesome new gear that's landed this past week, new music, and what's happening in the world that's rocking and rolling around us. Here's what's coming up this week. When it comes to new gear, you might have already seen it here at PMTVUK a couple of hours ago. We released a PMT exclusive colour of the amazing Schecter Omen Elite 6. In the world of pedals, Gibson have relaunched the Maestro brand. In the world of music, Judas Priest have announced that they're bringing back guitar player Andy Sneap. After a couple of weeks ago, they released a statement saying that they were going to continue as a four-piece without Andy, and Andy was a bit upset about this, but he kind of understood, but no, he's back in the fold, and they're going to continue as a five-piece. Away from that, Steve Vai has released a video, an in-depth video, detailing this absolutely crazy three-neck Ibanez Hydra guitar. We're going to get into this. And unfortunately, the sad news is that guitar amp-building legend, designer, iconic dude in general, Howard Alexander Dumble, has unfortunately passed away this week. And for our listening pleasure, we have new music from Joe Satriani, as well as details on a new album, and the guys and gals from Ghost. Right, let's get into it with some tasty new gear, and bear with me for a second. Da-da-da! This is the new PMT exclusive Schecter Omen Elite, and it's absolutely brilliant. It's an Omen Elite 6, and this has been out for a little while now. You might have already seen on the video here at PMTVUK. It might even be playing in the background when I'm speaking right now. But the Omen Elites are fantastic guitars that don't cost a lot of money, but kind of look pretty custom shoppy, don't they? This is a PMT exclusive because it features a trans black finish. So it's a see-through translucent finish where you can see that gorgeous poplar bill top. Schecter have an amazing way of making essentially custom shop guitars, but readily available to everyone. And now this is a colour that you can only get from us here at PMT. I'll link it down in the description box down below. Quick little spec overview. Mahogany body, that glorious gloss bill top. It's satin on the back as well. Satin maple neck with a bolt-on construction with an ultra-access heel. So you can get to that 24th extra jumbo fret, no problem at all. One volume, one tone, five-way switch, so you can get nice single coil tones. It's very versatile for looking as badass as it looks. Hip shot, string through bridge as well. Proper string through. Slim C profile neck, 14-inch radius, rosewood fingerboard, so it's lovely and flat. Perfect for cording and shredding away on. It's got a matching bill top, and it's just amazing. Again, limited edition, available only at pmtonline.co.uk in this lovely translucent see-through black colour. Badass. And yeah, like I said, if you want to hear it properly with all the in-depth specs and some beautiful video work of a built up PMTVUK from a couple of hours ago, click the link in the description or get yourself to the channel anyways and check out the review of the new PMT exclusive Schecter Omen Elite 6. Hell yeah. Other new gear to land this week, Gibson have relaunched the Maestro pedal brand. Now last week on DGN they kind of teased this and I spoke about that saying hopefully there's new Maestro pedals coming, and there are. We were all just hoping for the fuzz tone though. That's what Maestro is famous for. Back in the day, they created essentially the first ever fuzz pedal, the fuzz tone. So that's coming back. But so are four other pedals. There's five pedals in the new Maestro lineup, and they're all as beautiful as the last. All the regular ones that you'd expect, overdrive, distortion, chorus, and delay, as well as that lovely fuzz tone. But they've kind of expanded on the original fuzz tone and the rest of the pedals to look at. They're all very uniform. They look fantastic. Three controls that haven't overcomplicated things. They've kept them very simple. And as a simple guitar player, I like simple pedals because they're not hard to get a bad sound out of. You can get quite bad sounds when there's lots of effects in that happening, lots of knobs and parameters you can change. But they all feature three controls and a little switch in the middle. So on the fuzz tone, it switches it between the original classic mode, but also a more modern mode to kind of modernize it for the modern day fuzz player. There's a gate on the distortion, there's modulation effects on the delays to make it sound like tape flutters and stuff. Each pedal has its own two unique either voicings or two features you can switch between. So they're proper names. You have the Fuzz Tone FZM, the Maestro Fuzz Tone. You have the Maestro Ranger Overdrive, which is modeled after the world's most iconic valve amplifiers, according to Gibson. There's the Invader Distortion, there is the Comet Chorus, which is an analog bucket chorus, and the Discovery Delay, which is a bucket brigade delay. Very analog kind of designs, not too much witchcraft and wizardry happening in these pedals, which again, I really enjoy. But it's not just that. They've also announced that later on in this year, 2022, they're going to release a second batch of pedals. Now, this is the original first batch, these five. There's going to be a second batch, and there's also going to be more boutique limited edition numbers of these pedals as well. So they might be re-releasing like an exact copy of the original Fuzz tone. This is, from what I've heard on Gibson, it's very, very bloody close, but they might be releasing more period-looking correct, that kind of thing. So there's going to be some Gibson Custom Shop Maestro pedals coming in the second batch of these pedals later on this year, 2022. I'm very excited about this because Maestro are legendary pedals and Gibson are pretty damn legendary in their own right. So when you put them together, it, I don't know, it excites me and hopefully it excites you as well. Here's what Craig Hockenbury had to say, who's the director of engineering at Gibson Brands and the lead designer of Maestro pedals. That's one hell of a title, isn't it? I don't think there's any ceiling in terms of what Maestro can do. Given Maestro's history and legacy, it has certainly earned the right to play anywhere in the effects world. When it comes to Maestro in 2022, all you have to do is use your imagination. That's where Maestro will go and where Maestro will be. Well, I'm glad this mythical Fuzz pedal is back from the dead. Let me know what you think down below in the comments about Maestro. I can't wait to get my hands on one of the Fuzz tones. Next up, Andy Sneap is returning to Judas Priest as guitar player. Now, he hasn't been away that long. I was going to talk about this last week on DGN, but I didn't have any time. So a couple of weeks ago, Judas Priest released a statement saying they were moving forward as a fire-breathing four-piece without Andy Sneap. This would have been the first time they've been a four-piece since 1974. I think everyone knows Judas Priest is a five-piece. Andy Sneap was a bit upset about this. He was understandable, though. His statement was great. He was like, I'm very disappointed in what's happened. However, I totally get Rob Halford and like what he's doing isn't out of malice. They just want to move forward as a four-piece. Andy Sneap, if you don't know, produced their Firepower record in 2018. He's an amazing producer and amazing guitar player. And he joined from 2018. Ever since Glenn Tipton's Parkinson's diagnosis stopped him from playing so much. So we joined from 2018. Then they said a few weeks ago he wasn't going to be in the band anymore. Now everyone kicked off. There was a lot of backlash online about this. And I kind of agree with it because Judas Priest are a five-piece and Andy Sneap is a badass dude. So they've done a U-turn, maybe because of all the backlash. Maybe they might have done a rehearsal as a four-piece and went, nah, it doesn't sound that good. It might be nothing to do with the backlash, but yeah. Andy Sneap is back in the fold now. They're actually going through a tour as we speak, but it was put on hold after Richie Faulkner suffered his heart problem on stage, which I've spoke about in DGN before. But now he's well and better. He's all up and raring to go. There's videos on Instagram of him shredding away. So they're going to resume the tour in March, and they weren't going to resume it with Andy, but now Andy's back. This is the 50 Years of Heavy Metal tour, so it's a 50th anniversary for Judas Priest. I don't know why they want to do it as a four-piece, but no, he's back. And it's awesome, and I can't wait to see Judas Priest live here in the UK. Love Judas Priest, and yeah, they need to be a five-piece. Also, don't be surprised if Glenn Tipton rocks up and does some live shows on the tour. He's got a habit of just rocking up and doing a live cameo through the set and stuff. He can't play as much as he used to, but it's always cool to see Glenn back with Judas Priest. And yeah, that's Judas Priest's crack this week. Next up, who doesn't love Steve Vai? Steve Vai is an absolute madman, one of my guitar heroes, and overall, absolutely crazy son of a gun. He released a video of the new Hydra. Say, meet Hydra from Steve Vai and Ibanez. And Hydra, we've got a sneak of Hydra in the start of December. Hydra is, oh, what is Hydra? Is it a guitar? I think it's a guitar. It's a three-neck guitar with a harp on it. There's piezos, there's MIDI. It's absolutely crackers. And in this video, Steve Vai goes in depth through this guitar. He explains what everything is, what everything does, all to a beautiful soundtrack. Again, Inviolate is coming very, very soon, Steve Vai's new album. He just had to cancel the American tour, so that's a shame, but this guitar is making up for it in our guitarists' heads right now. So to look at this guitar, it is a triple neck comprising of a 7-string, a 12-string, a 4-string, 3/4-length bass guitar, and a 13-harp-string thing, for good measure. The Hydra features single coil, humbucking, piezo, MIDI, and sustainer pickups. There's a floating bridge and a hardtail tremolo. There's phase splitters, half fretless necks, so there's frets only halfway up the neck, and more wild specs than I can fit in this little episode of DGN. I'll link the video down below in the description. Please check it out. It's an absolute crackers thing. Imagine if Ibanez make this as like a one-off or a affordable version. I'd buy one just to have on the wall. I'd have it above the fireplace in my living room. It would look absolutely kick-ass. Now, alongside this, Steve Vai is releasing an NFT. I still don't really know what an NFT is. I think it's a digital license thing that only one person can own or buy, I think. And this NFT is an in-depth video of the Hydra. And I think they're auctioning this off the same day Inviolate comes out, which is January 28th. Not long now. So yeah, if you want to buy NFT of that, whatever that means, that's available too. I think bidding starts at $1,300, and enjoy your NFT, whoever buys it. I'm just going to sit back here and enjoy the Hydra for now, and Violate when it comes out. Here's what Steve Vai has to say about the Hydra. I feel this instrument has the potential to be historical. You don't say. The video's been out like a day, and everyone in the world is talking about it because it looks historical. It looks prehistorical. It looks like a dinosaur guitar, baby. It's absolutely crackers. It's unique in various ways, and its construction is inspired. And there's a song that was written on it that honors the potential of the instrument. I reckon you could play loads of songs on it. You could play Running with the Devil on one while you're playing a harp quartet on the other one, or while playing a bass guitar and fretless stuff. I think this guitar is awesome. I love Steve Vai. I love it when Steve does crazy stuff like this. Let me know what you think of the Hydra down below in the old comment section. Now, in other news, a lot sadder than the Hydra, Howard Alexander Dumble has passed away. He passed away on January the 18th. A statement from his Instagram page read that it is with great sadness that we announced the passing of Howard. His work brought joy and inspiration to countless musicians and engineers. May he rest in peace. If you don't know who Alexander Howard Dumble is, he was a very secretive dude who made some of the most amazing, most touch-responsive amplifiers on the planet. Stevie Ray Vaughan, Robin Ford, John Mayer, Joe Bonamassa all love these amplifiers. Joe Perry was one of the last people to get a beautiful amp modified by the legend that was Howard Alexander Dumble. You can tell by the prices, these amps are mythical. So when we talk about Klon pedals and stuff, the 1959 Les Pauls, and Fender No Casses and stuff like that, these amps go in the same bracket. They go from everywhere from 50 grand all the way up to $250,000. They're some of the most mythical amps on the planet, and they've been recreated so many times. Like the Steel String Singer, the Overdrive Special, the Dumbulator, are amplifiers that have this kind of caliber and pedestal. There's so many people have tried to copy, but no one's kind of managed it. It's a great way to get that kind of vibe of an amp, but unless you've got 200 grand, you can't really get it. These are the amps used by legendary guitar players. They didn't really cost a lot back then, but they've kind of just been held up in such high regard. They're some of the most sought after amplifiers of the modern era, crafted by Howard Alexander Dumble. Eric Clapton used them, Kenny Wayne Shepherd, Carlos Santana, all users of Dumble amplifiers. They're amazing things. Now, Guitar World, a couple of years ago, had the pleasure of interviewing Mr. Dumble, because he's very quiet. He doesn't like the glitz and glamour of showbiz like other people do. So of his amp-making philosophy, this is what Mr. Dumble had to say. I try to be very flexible. I've always been aware of whatever I make had to be crafted with the best intentions. Never have anything shoddy. Always make sure that it works and looks perfect. The actual technique I use to get the sounds that I go after have evolved extensively. It's a growing process. That's the toughest thing about staying with one thing. You're always thinking of new ways to do it. The guy was a genius and will be sorely missed. Even if you don't agree with the whole ethos of having really expensive daft amps like $250,000 Overdrive Specials and stuff, you have to appreciate that he didn't charge that for them. It's just kind of what they are now. The same way that Bill, who invented the Klon, doesn't like the fact that they cost $5,000 now. So you just got to appreciate the fact that Dumble made these fantastic amplifiers, which are regarded so highly now that they're this crazy money and have this kind of status. He'll be sorely missed. Please give some respects to Howard Alexander Dumble in the comments, your favorite Dumble amp, your favorite Dumble player. Now, I just had to film this bit because the news broke after we finished shooting DGN, the unfortunate news that Meatloaf has passed away at the age of 74. It was announced by his agent. Now, Meatloaf was an absolute legend. Musician, actor, he did stand-up comedy at one point as well. The guy was an all-rounder, and boy could the guy sing. Absolutely unbelievable. If all you know, if you're watching this, of Meatloaf is Bat Out of Hell, for one, you probably only know the chorus, so listen to the entire Bat Out of Hell song. It's an absolute masterpiece. The album is a masterpiece, and the song is a masterpiece. Let alone all the fantastic work that Meatloaf has done over the years, whether it be his extensive back catalogue of music or all the acting stuff. Musicians from around the world, actors, pop stars, rock stars, and everyone in between have been sharing the love for Meatloaf and remembering him online. So feel free to do the same in the comments, the same as Alexander Howard Dumble.
It's been a sucky week for music, musicians, rock musicians this week, but yeah, I just had to include it, the fact that Meatloaf is no longer with us, which is a massive shame. I'll be blasting Meatloaf as loud as I can today, and I hope you do too. I'll be doing it all weekend, to be fair.
Now next up, what new music has landed this past week? Well, first off, guitar extraordinaire, guitar virtuoso, modern-day guitar hero, Mr. Joe Satriani has only gone and released Sahara, a hypnotic new single, which has a beautiful vibe to it. The video's great as well, it's like a lovely reddish hue. It starts off in a mirrored room when he's playing his mirror Satch Ibanez model with his big old sunglasses on. Great video and great song. This also signals an announcement for his new 19th studio album, The Elephants of Mars. Is that right? The Elephants of Mars, yes. I had it written down, but as I was saying it, I was like, it can't be The Elephants of Mars, but no, it is The Elephants of Mars, and that's getting released on April 8th. Satch is always super creative, isn't he? He's got his tone, he's got his vibe, but he always tries to expand it and kind of take things to the next level. And that's what he said when it came to writing during the pandemic, because it's been lockdown. He's had a lot of time to sit and write and kind of really, really get things out for this new album. He's not just like shredding away on an album which comes out every 8 months or something. He's had time to sit and think about this, and I'm excited to hear the whole album. Here's what Satch had to say. I want to show people that an instrumental guitar album can contain far more creative and entertaining elements than I think people are using right now. We did everything. We tried the craziest ideas. Unsurprisingly, it's Satch. And we entertained every notion that we had about turning something backwards, upside down, just to see what could happen. You can pre-order this beautiful new album. I'll link the pre-order in the description box down below, as well as a link to check out the video for Sahara. It's epic. Great song. Let me know what you think. Now, last but certainly not least, Ghost. Do you know the band Ghost? The way they look and that? They've just released a new single, Call Me Little Sunshine. This announcement also goes along with their fifth studio album announcement release called Impera. Yeah. Ghosts are weird for me. People love Ghosts. Everyone's like, Dagan, you should love Ghosts. When I first saw a picture of Ghosts, I was like, that looked pretty cool. I'm gonna give Ghosts a listen. I've never really got that into Ghosts. I think some of the really old stuff, the kind of Sabbath-y stuff, was cool, but I've heard lots of poppy stuff, and I like pop music. Pop music's great. But I don't know. It just kind of wasn't really my vibe. But this song is. It's got a great hooky riff. The riff, in fact, the video is crackers, because it's Ghost, and it'd be crackers if it was a great song, it'd be crackers if it was a crack song, crap song. It's just what Ghosts do. But I dig Call Me Little Sunshine. It's good riff, and his singing is excellent. Tobias Forge is an amazing frontman. This is the latest Papa Emeritus as well, Papa Emeritus 4, who was unleashed in 2020. It might be internally because Tobias Forge used to play in a band called Crash Diet, which were one of my favourite bands growing up. And he played guitar alongside Dave Leppard before Martin Sweet joined the band. And that's where I always know him from. So when I hear Ghost, I'm like, it's not Crash Diet, is it? Obviously very different bands. But yeah, they've released a new single, Call Me Little Sunshine, as well as announcing their fifth studio album, Impera. This counters their single, which is also going to be on Impera, Hunter's Moon, which came out a little while ago. This kind of counters that. And yeah, let me know what you think of Ghost down below. Do you have the same thoughts as me? Is there any Ghost songs that I should listen to go, I like Ghost, because I'm totally open to the idea of liking Ghost. This just never really been on my radar. So let me know what Ghost songs I should listen to if you're a Ghost fanatic out there. And also, with that, let me know what you think of the rest of the chat here from DGN, episode 23, I think. That's a lot of weeks. The new Schecters from PMT Exclusive Schecters, the new Maestro Pedals, Steve Vai's amazing new guitar, the crack with Judas Priest, the unfortunate passing of Howard Alexander Dumble, new music from Satch and Ghost. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. That's it for this week. Look after yourselves. Have a good one. Cheers.